Condylar fractures and the management. Condylar injuries can occur after road traffic accidents simply by falling off stairs or falling on the ground, by interpersonal violence or any other high impact injury on your chin. How can we treat it and does it need treatment? Watch this video to know all about condylar fractures. Hi, I'm Dr. Shreya Krishna, your trusted oral and maxillofacial surgeon from New Delhi. So what is the condyle? The condyle is the head of your lower jaw from which all the movements of the lower jaw take place. The condyle is slightly broader in shape, and before it meets the rest of the lower jaw, there is a very thin part of the condyle called the condylar neck. So being very thin, this area is a very fracture prone area, especially when there is impact on the chin area. The forces are directly transmitted on both sides of the condyle. So let's say you have a condylar fracture which can be seen on x-rays. In which circumstance does it need treatment? And if it does, what are the treatment options available to you? So I will divide condylar fracture treatment according to the age in which you are in. If you are a parent and your child is under the age of 5 years, then if there is a condylar fracture which is detected, the treatment varies very much from how we would treat an adult. Condylar fractures in a young child lead to lot of pooling up of blood into the temporomandibular joint or the joint of which condyle is a part. The head of the condyle is very large in a child and it fractures more easily than the other part of the condyle. Once this fractures, the entire temporomandibular joint gets filled up or pulled up with blood. This blood later during the weeks organizes into bone. Since the child is in the growing potential and in the growing years, formation of bone happens very readily. So if this clot or the blood that gets formed becomes bone during the healing stages, then the joint becomes totally fused and filled with bone. This makes it impossible for the child to open the mouth. Hence, if the child is less than 5 years of age, condylar fractures are never fixed with wires and ideally not even plated. Usually, they are left for active physiotherapy and active exercises, and if at all the fracture is so bad that it does need some kind of fixation, then the fixation on the wiring is for a very short period of time. Moving on to adults and children above 5 years of age. In this circumstance, again, it depends on the displacement of the condyle. If the condyle is still stuck to the stump of the mandible but is only rotated to a certain degree, which is less than 30 degrees, and this kind of fracture is present on only one side of the condyle, this can be treated by IMF. The full form of IMF is intermaxillary fixation. Ideally, if the occlusion or the bite is achieved by just the IMF, then patient is left on wiring for 3 to 4 weeks. If the occlusion is not achieved, then initially the patient is left on elastic wiring and then converted into steel wiring. Let's say the fracture is displaced, so it is not in this form where the angle is between 0 to 30 degrees, but it is beyond 30 degrees. This is called displacement. In these circumstances, and if the child is young or if it is a young adult and the occlusion derangement is considerable, both the options are open to us. Plating of the condyle is also an option. IMF of the condyle is also an option. There are a lot of clinical scenarios dictate which one to go for. Last, if the condyle is dislocated from the stump of the lower jaw, it is not in contact and it is moved either completely laterally or completely medially from the rest of the lower jaw, fixing this kind of a condyle with plates and screws is mandatory. If it is not done, it leads to later reduced range of mobility of the lower jaw, permanent bite issues of the lower jaw, reduction in one side of the height of the face of the lower jaw, and future TM joint pains. This scenario can also occur in a case which was the previous case where the dislocation or the displacement of the condyle was more than 30 degrees. However, there both options can still be considered. The last scenario I want to discuss is you have bilateral condylar fracture, in which case both the sides of your condyle are either displaced, dislocated, or just deviated. In this case, ideally, when both sides are fractured, one side should be fixed by plates and screws, and the other side can be left to treatment by either IMF with elastics, IMF with wires, or nothing at all. If you're somebody with a condylar fracture and want to know how to proceed, please drop in a text, comment, or subscribe to our channel. Thank you.